Why would someone want to kill journalist Pavel Sheremet? In addition to his radio and TV work, he wrote for Ukraine's leading investigative news outlet, Ukrainska Pravda, that is strongly critical of governments. The site is owned by his widow, Olena Pritula. Sevgil Musayeva Borovik is the editor-in-chief. Today in the Ukrainska Pravda offices, they are frustrated by the lack of progress in the official police investigation. In the view of the journalists, this case began to resemble a horrible incident from the past at Ukrainska Pravda. Another prominent broadcaster named Georgi Gongadze was the co-founder of that news site. Gongadze was murdered in the year 2000.
Відрізання голови від тіла.
Я просто дійсно обіцяю, дуже дав відповідні доручення.
The investigation showed that the Ukrainian government was involved. Recordings believed to be of the former president Leonid Kuchma capture him ordering Gongadze to be kidnapped or worse. On the same tapes, the former interior minister was heard confirming that Gongadze was under surveillance. Three policemen and an interior ministry official were eventually convicted for the killing, but no one has been brought to justice for ordering Gongadze's murder. Is history repeating itself?
During many years, Ukrainian police officers have been linked with murders, tortures, kidnappings, also against Ukrainian reporters. This is an absolutely general practice of our life. So
you personally kind of didn't trust the police?
We cannot exclude it. We cannot exclude that police could be linked with this murder, with execution of this murder.
Again, there is evidence that the journalists of Ukrainska Pravda were under surveillance before the crime was committed. Documents were mailed to them anonymously.
Власне, стало зрозуміло, що хтось слідкує за роботою Української правди і слідкує достатньо уважно, оскільки вони були навіть і про ті теми, які ми так і не встигли зробити. Але здебільшого це було повідомлення у Фейсбуці, це були телефонні розмови, власне, які робилися з номеру, і це також були повідомлення у Viber.
Who was conducting this surveillance?
Моя власна думка, що це робила Служба безпеки України. І джерела мої, які працюють навколо адміністрації президента, а також у правоохоронних органах, кажуть, що власне це є аналітичні записки, які готує Служба безпеки України.
On February 8th, 7 months after Pavel's murder, the Minister of Interior held a press conference. He announced that the government believed Pavel was murdered because of his work. The minister denied that anyone at Ukrainska Pravda had been under government surveillance.
Ми отримали від Служби безпеки України відповідь, що в результаті проведеної у них перевірки такого слідження не було. Такої слежки не було і в національній поліції.
Police surveillance of journalists is a regular occurrence in Ukraine.
Ukrainian politicians and law enforcement officers every time deny every suspicious things. This is a common practice. But every time they will lie about this, they will deny it.
I'm sure your friends ask you, Who do you think did this? Why was this done? Why was he killed?
Pavel's murdering, that was not random shooting or random stabbing on the street. That was very well organized, very well planned, and very well executed.
People who never did it, I don't think that they can do that. Maybe it's people from security service of Belarus, of Russia, of Ukraine. I think that it was prepared by people who worked or still work for security service. But what country? It's the main question.
Three days after the bombing, Pavel Sheremet was laid to rest in his home country of Belarus. The police in Ukraine seem no closer to finding his murderers than they were at that time. At the Kiev intersection where he was killed, there is still a small private memorial that is carefully maintained.
Ну, Павло був так вплетений у життя редакції, що іноді відчувається навіть це просто місце, яке заповнював його сміх, або його якісь жарти, або його надзвичайна міміка. І власне цей простір відчуваєш таку пустоту, але ніхто не може заповнити.
That documentary was produced by the Organized Crime and Corruption Reporting Project and Ukrainian Public Television.